So we were discussing best first search, in which we have seen there are two variation of best first search. First one was like greedy best first search, and then a star algorithm, or we can say a optimal algorithm. So what was the idea in best first search? We use an evaluation function for each node. Fn provides an estimate for the total cost, and I expand the nodes n with the smallest function only. Rest of the nodes will not be expanded. So how we can implement this? Order the nodes in fringe, increasing order of the cost. That is, we can make a priority queue on which basis we can insert the node and can remove the node. So what are the special cases? First one is greedy best first search, and then a star search. So in greedy best first search, we have seen that greedy best first search algorithm always select the path which appears best at that moment. It is a combination of DFS and BFS algorithm. As we know that in BFS and DFS, we look for adjacent nodes only based upon the structure of the algorithm, like whether it is a breadth first or a depth first. So both BFS and DFS blindly explore paths without considering any cost function. So what the idea in the greedy best first search? So we look for the most promising node which we have to expand to in order to reach to the goal. So let's see, best first search allow us to take the advantage of both the algorithms. With the help of best first search, at each step we can choose the most promising node. How we can choose the most promising node? With the help of that heuristic function. Heuristic function can give you an idea that which node is most promising and which node is not that promising, means the cost is more in that particular node. So in the best first search, we expand the node which is closest to the goal node, and the closest cost is estimated by the heuristic function. That is, heuristic function can be taken as f of n is equal to g of n. So we are there is a mistake. This is h of n. I will correct this. This is h of n. H of n is equal to g of n, and here h of n estimated cost from node n to the goal. We use a priority queue to store cost of the node, so the implementation is a variation of VFS. We just need to change queue into priority queue. So with the help of priority queue, we can implement this greedy best first search. And for example, we are having this graph. Here you can see that we are having a source node and we are having the goal node I. So we have to reach from source to I. Now we can see what are the steps this greedy best first search algorithm will follow. So as the algorithm say that we have to maintain a priority queue based upon the cost. Let's see how we can move from S to other nodes. So firstly, we are having this root node, that is S. And we will put this start node into the priority queue. So here we are having this priority queue. We have put there only S. And then we will remove S from the priority queue and process the unvisited neighbors of the S into the priority queue in the order that the minimum cost nodes will come first. So let's see what are the neighbors of S, A, B, and C. And the cost is 3, 6, 5. So make them in ascending order. So firstly, A will be there, then C, and then B. So priority queue now contains A, C, B. Why? Because cost of A is 3, cost of C is 5, and the cost of B is 6. So make a priority queue and put them in ascending order of the cost. Now this much has been done. As you can see here that we have crossed the S. Now S has been removed from the priority queue because we have picked its neighbor. Now we are moving towards the goal. Now what will happen? We will remove a node which is in front of this priority queue, which is the node. The node is A. Now let's pick the node A and insert the neighbors of A in the ascending order. Let's see. So remove A from the priority queue and process unvisited neighbors of A to the priority queue. Who are the unvisited neighbors? These are D and E. And we have to make them in ascending order. As you can see, the cost of moving from A to A is 8 and A to D is 9. So let's move. Now priority queue contains C, B, E, D. Now you can see here we have removed the S, cross is there, and we have removed A, cross is there. Now what are the remaining nodes in the priority queue? In the ascending order, these are C, B, then E, and then D. in the ascending order. Now, which node is in the front of priority queue? As you can see here, we are having node C. Now, let's remove node C from the priority queue and add its neighbor in the ascending order into the priority queue. So let's move. Remove C from the priority queue and process unwisted neighbors of C. Now here we can see here that we are removing C, and who are the nodes of the neighbors of C? There is only H. So we now put this H into the priority queue in the ascending order. As you can see, the cost of this C to H is 7. So let's see. Priority queue now contains B, H, E, and D in this order. What is the cost of B? You can see here it is 6. H, where is H? It is 7. And then E, it is 8. And D, it is 9. So we are maintaining the priority queue order. Now, which node is in the front of this queue? The node is B. Let's remove the node B and put the unlisted nodes and neighbors of B into the priority queue. So let's move. Remove B from the priority queue and process unlisted neighbors of B to the priority queue. Here we have removed the node B. Who are the neighbors? F and G. And the cost is 12 and 14 respectively. Let's insert them into the priority queue in the ascending order. Now, what is the structure of priority queue now? H, E, D, F, and G. So in this manner, we can see here that we have maintained the ascending order in the priority queue. And what are the nodes we have removed from the priority queue till now? S, then C, then A. No, sorry, S, then A, then C, then B. Now these are the remaining nodes in the priority queue. So which node is in the front? Now H is in the front of the queue. We will remove node H. Let's see what are the neighbors of H. Okay, remove H from the priority queue since our goal is I. Now you can see here the goal has met here. So as soon as the goal is reached, we will quit and return the result. So in this manner, you can see that these are the steps taken by the greedy best first search in this example. So what are the takeaways in this? What are the advantages of using this greedy best first search? Best first search can switch between BFS and DFS by gaining the advantage of both the algorithm. How it is switching? It gives an illusion that it is switching between BFS and DFS. Why? Because it is maintaining a priority queue and can move in any direction, either in breadth or in depth. So this algorithm is more efficient than BFS and DFS. So what are the disadvantages? It can behave as an unguided depth first search in the worst case scenario. In case your heuristic function is not that much good, then it will work as the unguided depth first search. It can get stuck in a loop as DFS. If there is any loop, then the drawback, which is in DFS, it is can also be there, because if there is a loop, it will get stuck in that loop. This algorithm is not optimal. So what we have to taken care that performance of the algorithm depends on how well the cost or evaluation function is designed. So it totally depends upon your heuristic function. If your heuristic function is not that much accurate, not that much efficient, you will not get that good result. It totally depends upon your heuristic function. So this is the quick revision of your previous class. Let's discuss today's topic, that is A star search. So today's topic is another informed search technique is A star search. So what is A star search? Let's see. A star search is the most commonly known form of the best first search. As we have seen that in informed search, first we have studied best first search. It is having two special cases. First one was greedy best first search, and second one is A star search. This is the subset of your best first search. Now, it is one of the best and popular technique used in path finding and graph traversal. It is one of the best and popular technique to used in path finding and graph traversal. As you can see that many games, you have to pick any like a star or anything. You look at the smallest or the path which is optimal to reach that particular star. Or if you are talking about cricket games, then if there is a ball, then which player will go and pick that ball? So we have to find the optimal path and the shortest path that they are like 11 players are there and who will run and pick that ball. So this algorithm can be used in that scenario. So it is one of the best and popular technique used in path finding and graph traversal. So A star search algorithm finds the shortest path through the search space using the heuristic function. Now, with the help of heuristic function, it can provide you the shortest path. Now, how it is different from greedy search? Let's see. This search algorithm expands less search trees and provide optimal result faster. As you aware that in best first search, we are not expanding those nodes which are not in line of that heuristic function. So in A star search algorithm, we use search heuristic as well as the cost to reach the node. Now here we use two parameters. First one is heuristic value from source node to the node we are traveling, and there is also a cost factor we will be included to reach the goal node. How we can use these two parameters, we will discuss. Hence, we can combine both cost as following, and the sum is called as fitness number. Now let's see what are these costs. F of n is equal to g of n plus h of n. Now, what is h of n? H of n is the cost to reach from node n to goal node. And what is g of n? Cost of reach node n from start node. And Fn is estimated cost of the cheapest solution. Think about there is a source node and there is a current node. Now from moving from source node to current node, what is the cost? It is denoted by g of n. And from current node, where is the goal node? It is denoted by your h of n. So we will discuss these parameters one by one. Now each point in the search space, only those node is expanded which have the lowest cost value of f of n, and the algorithm terminates when the goal node is found. As we have included two factors, first is g of n and second is h of n. G of n is your cost to reach node n from the start node. As you are on the current node, what is the cost from your start node, and what is the cost remaining from current node to the goal node? As I am giving you an example, suppose you are moving from Lucknow to New Delhi, and then firstly you if there is you wants to have a stop in the Bareilly, you are looking for what is the cost from Lucknow to Bareilly, and this is g of n, and what is the remaining cost from Bareilly to New Delhi, this is h of n, that is cost to reach from node n to the goal node. And goal n node n is your what your current state. So let's discuss these parameters one by one. First one is your G. What is G? The cost of moving from the initial node to the current node. What is G? It is the cost of moving from the initial node to the current node. That is from start node to the current node. Suppose you are in Bareilly right now. So what is the cost you have spent right now from Lucknow to Bareilly? This is denoted by G. Basically, it is the sum of all the nodes that have been visited since leaving the first node. So, suppose you have first taken and stop somewhere in between Lucknow to Bareilly, then what is the cost from that there, then the rest cost from that particular stoppage to the Bareilly. And these all the cost is summing up into the G parameter. And what is H? H is also known as the heuristic value. It is the estimated cost of moving from the current node to the final node. Now you are in Bareilly route now, and from Bareilly you have to move to the New Delhi. So it will give you an estimated cost that okay, how much kilometer is remaining from Bareilly to New Delhi, and as per your ride, suppose 1 kilometer will be charged as 10 rupees. So how many kilometers are there, and then how will be how fare will be there. So you can estimate some things, but suppose this is the distance you are talking about, that suppose it is 100 kilometer from Bareilly to New Delhi, and suppose if there is any issue in that path, your car driver has moved in another road and then move from here and there, then there is a difference in the actual cost and the estimated cost. And when you get the actual cost, when you actually reach to the New Delhi, then only you can find out, okay, this much cost I have spent from reaching Lucknow to New Delhi. But At the moment when you are in a very lean, you can just estimate that how much cost I have to give in order to reach to the New Delhi based upon the heuristic of the distance you are having in hand and the rate at which you have to pay to the driver. So H is what? It is also known as the heuristic value. It is the estimated cost of moving from the current node to the final node. So the actual cost cannot be calculated until the final node is reached. As I told you that you cannot give an actual estimate until you reach to the New Delhi, because there in a real scenario anything can happen in that particular path. So suppose your ride is charged based upon the time taken. Suppose if there is any from Bareilly to New Delhi, it takes 2 hours to reach, and suppose there is any jam into the road and it takes 4 hours, but you estimated that it will take 2 hours, so I have to pay this much of amount. But in a reality, when you reach to the New Delhi, it is 4 hours taken, so you have to pay more. So that was the actual cost, but you estimated that you can reach at this much of sum. So there is a difference between the estimated cost and the actual cost. So, but what we have to taken care that this estimated cost cannot must not be overestimated. That you like proactively think that okay, suppose the road construction work is going on that particular route, so it will take more time. So I will think that it will take 5 hours, but in actually you reached in 4 hours. So you have spent more on the estimated cost. So this we have to taken care. So see, these things are working in a real scenario. Similarly, we are trying to implement the real scenario things that are human, how humans think that I have to reach from Lucknow to New Delhi. So what are the scenarios and what is the cost I have to spend if I move from directly or have some stoppage. These are the things we are now trying to put into an algorithm with all the scenarios, and then we can see that they can take an intelligent decision by giving you an optimal search result. And what is the last parameter? This is F. It is a sum of G and H. That is F equal to G plus H. On the basis of this F, the minimum value will be selected. So let's have an example. As you can see, we are having 5 nodes. Start node is A and the goal node is E. And here you can see the cost is given from A to B is 2, B to E is 3, A to C is 1, C to D is 1, and D to E is 1. Now, how to apply this A star algorithm? Let's see. We have to use that F of n is equal to G of n plus H of n. So, firstly, start with node A, and then we can see here that we can reach either B or C. But what is the value of reaching from node A to node B? As you can see, it is 2. In the previous question, you can see it is 2. Let me have that preview, this one here also, so that you can find it out very clearly. Okay, so see here, we are moving from node A, right? And then we can move either in two direction, either B or C. So what is the G value? G value is your current node is B. If you are talking about B, how you reach to this current node, what is the cost you have spent? It is 2. And what is your heuristic that you can it will take 3 from B to E. So G plus H, 2 plus 3. So what is the F value? It is 5. Do you understand? And here in C, this is the current node. What is the G value from reaching A to C? The current value, G value is 1. And what is the heuristic value? What is the heuristic value? You can see here that from C, you have to take 2 cos to reach to this E. So 1 plus 2 is 3. This you understand? Everyone? Do you get the concept of G plus H? How we are calculating this? Very pretty simple. G value is the cost from source node to the current node. What is the cost? It is 2. And what is H value? This is the estimated cost, like your heuristic value, that how much it will be spent to move from B to E. It is 3. So 2 plus 3, it is 5. And here in C, what is the G value? It is from A to C. You can see we are in node C right now. So from A to C, it is 1. So G value is 1 and H value is 2. 1 plus 1 is 2. And this you understand, everyone? Do you get the idea? Shall we move? Do you get the concept of G plus H, everyone? Yes or no? Okay, so pretty simple one, that we G value is from source node to the current node. This is your G value, and H value is from current node to your destination. That is your goal. So 2 plus 3, it is 5. And here 1 plus, and this C to D 1 and D to E 1. So 1 plus 1, 2. 1 plus 2 is 3. Now, the smallest value is F. The smallest value is F of C. So we'll choose node C. So here now node C is chosen. So let's see how to move again. Now B will not be expanded. We will expand the C right now. So let's expand the C. Now you can see here we are on D right now. Now, so what is the G value of D? It is the sum of all the nodes you have visited. So 1 plus 1, that you can see here, 1 plus 1, it is 2. It is the G value. And what is the H value? It is from D to E, that is 1. So what is the F value? It is 3. Okay. So what is the G value at node D? G value is the total cost you have spent from this Lucknow to Bareilly. Then there was an stoppage in between. I do not remember which is the city between Lucknow and Bareilly. And suppose any X city is there. So A to X is 1 and X to Bareilly is 1. So this is the G value, that is 2. And what is the H value? That from Bareilly to New Delhi, it is 1. D to E is 1. So this is the H value. So 2 plus 1 is 3. Now we are not having any other choice, so we will expand D right now. So let's move. So node D is chosen. So now expand this node D. Now you can see here, let me have that diagram once again. Here also. Okay, so till now we are reached here that 2 plus 2 is 4 and 1 plus 2 is 3, then 2 plus 1 is 3. This is the F value. Now node D is chosen. Expand this node. Here you can see that we have reached to this E, and this is the goal node. Node E is chosen. And what is the G value at node E? It is 1 plus 1 plus 1, that is 3. Here you can see A to C is 1, C to D is 1, then D to E is 1. So 1 plus 1 plus 1 is 3. And what is the H value? There is no H value because we are at the goal node. So it is 0. Vinay is asking, sir, how will we calculate H of N? Will we be traversing through all the nodes before running the algorithm? See, this is H of N is depends upon your, this is your heuristic function, right? So you predict it either, it depends upon your, how well you implemented this heuristic function. It totally depend upon that. So as I told you that you predict, as I have given you an example that from Bareilly to Lucknow, either you go for your distance, that suppose it is 200 kilometer and 1 kilometer cost is 10 rupees. So for 200 kilometer, how much you have to pay? Either you look for your timing. It depends upon you, how you are implementing this H of N, because everything depends upon H of N. G value is the accurate value you are getting because you have traversed that. But what you have to predict is heuristic value, your H value. Now, how you are predicting H value, it depends upon the context of the problem. As I am giving you an example that you have reached from Lucknow to Bareilly, you have the accurate cost that how much you have spent from Lucknow to Bareilly. Now, from Bareilly to New Delhi, how much you have to spend, this is your H value. Now, how you can calculate this H value? You can either take the formula that there is a 200 kilometer from Bareilly to New Delhi and 1 kilometer cost is 10 rupees. Then how much you have to spend? In this manner, you can estimate that H value, or you have another idea that, okay, don't go for that distance. There may be some construction work is going on the road. Then we have to move some another area. Then it distance will be more. As I told you that we have to avoid the overestimation. So we think that, okay, there will be some issue in that area. Let's not discuss that distance kind of thing. Go for timing. Suppose it takes 2 hours from Bareilly to New Delhi, and that we will charge on the basis of hours. If 1 hour is that much will be paid, then how will we fare to the 2 hours? So it totally depends upon you how very you implement this H of N value. As this is the example I am giving you, in which you can see that there are the correct values. But if there are other paths also, you can see there is an issue of overestimation and underestimation also. In Dennis Ritchie book, you can find this A star algorithm where you can see that much scenario that here we can go for overestimation kind of thing. So this is the thing. In the example, if we are at node C, how will the system know the cost of traveling till destination? That is what I am telling you. So Shari Singh, sir, please repeat for node B why it is 2 plus 2. Oh, sorry, it is 2 plus 3. Okay, 1 minute. There is a mistake. Let me correct it. Here we are. We are here. This is 2 plus 3 actually. This is 2 plus 3 is 5. This is like typo is there. This is 2 plus 3 is 5. I will correct it. Okay. Okay, I will correct it. This is 2 plus 3 is 5. This is actually 2 plus 3 is 5. Here it is wrongly written 2 plus 2 is 4. So, okay. Yes, let me read. Tushar, it is typo. This is 2 plus 3 is 4. I will correct this. So Vinay, yes, it is just an estimate. That is what I am telling. H value is just an estimated value. So in this example, if we are at node C, how will the system know the cost of traveling till destination? So it will depend upon your estimated value, that is your H value, and how you are implementing this H value. It depends upon your algorithm, that which factor you are taking into account, as I am giving you, that either you go for distance or therefore time. Okay. Here there's a typo in this diagram. I will correct this. Thanks for pointing. This is 2 plus 3 is 5. Okay. This it is not 2 plus 2 is 4. It is 2 plus 3 is 5. I will correct this. So this is how we reach this goal node. As you can see, G value is 3 and H value is 0 because we don't have to estimate anything. We have reached the goal node. So node E is chosen. So let's discuss what are the takeaways. As you can see, GN value, this is the cost to reach node N from start node. And what is this H of N? This is very important. This is cost to reach from node N to the goal node. And how, if you are already aware that this much cost will be taken, then there is a no issue of any intelligence kind of thing, right? This is simple 2 plus 2 equal to 4, right? Understand? If you are aware, as I am giving you an example, that cost is accurately printed, and you can, as we are human, we can find out that, okay, this is 1 plus 1 plus 3, this will be the heuristic cost, this much and this much. We can analyze very easily. But in a real scenario, until and unless we visit all nodes, we cannot identify the heuristic value. So we have to predict it based upon some data we are having. So this H value is the cost to reach from node N to goal node. So let's see, A star algorithm returns the path which occurred first, and it does not search for all the remaining nodes, as we have seen that we are not visiting the node B, rest of the nodes, because it is costly already. So we visit only those nodes which are not costly. The efficiency of A star algorithm depends on the quality of heuristic. As Vinay was asking how you are finding this heuristic function. So heuristic, as I told you, heuristic is what you are just hit and trial method. You are looking for that, okay, this heuristic you can apply on. So A star algorithm expand all nodes which satisfy the condition only. only those nodes will be expanded which satisfy the condition of f of n, that f of n is value is less. So it totally depends upon your heuristic value. If it is you are having a quality heuristic function, you will get good result. If your heuristic function is not that much good, you will not get a good result. So what are the advantages in this? A star algorithm is one of the best pathfinding algorithm. A star such algorithm is optimal. It is complete as long as branching factor is finite and cost at every action is fixed. What is branching factor? Can anyone tell me? Do you aware what is a branching factor? What is the branching factor of a binary tree? Tell me the branching factor of a binary tree. What is the branching factor of a binary tree? This is 2. Very good. Means number of branches you are having. Maximum branches. So in binary tree, we can have maximum branches 2 only. So this is the branching factor. So when this A star algorithm is complete, if your branching factor is finite, if it is infinite kind of thing, there will be an issue. It will not a complete and cost at every action is fixed. Only this then scenario it is complete. This algorithm can solve very complex problem. So these are the advantages. What are the disadvantages? It does not always produce the shortest path as it mostly based upon heuristic and approximation. As I given you an example that you can predict, you can just assume that this much cost will be there. So it is an approximation only. You can either overestimate things also. So it does not always produce the shortest path. The main drawback of A star is memory requirement, as it keeps all generated nodes in the memory. So it is not practical for various large scale problem. What is the problem? It is consuming more memory. As we can see that from node A, we are moving to node B and C. So it is taking both B and C into memory. And with, until unless it take those nodes into the memory, it not able to process them. So the main drawback of A star is memory requirement, as it keeps all generated nodes in the memory. So it is not practical for various large scale problems.